There he is. Okay, everybody. Today, what we're gonna do is just a beautiful day, light winds, decided to come out and film, and we're gonna do some early rig fishing. Look at that nice speckled trout, first thing. First cast, nice speckled trout now. What I'm doing is, as I'm gonna show y'all, we have a light incoming tide, and setting up on rigs like this, beautiful little speckled trout, we can throw him back. But what we're doing is, we're actually, the tide's going into all of this stuff right here that was an old rig before Katrina. And what we're gonna do is, we're gonna fish the front of it, because that's where you should fish on an incoming tide. You should fish the upward current side of it, and fish the structure that's there. So I just pulled up, that was actually my first cast. I'm gonna throw again. I'm throwing right up in by some pilings and then some pipes right here. And we're gonna see if we can find the place where the fish are actually really located, and understanding that when the current's going through these rigs like this, the fish tend to sit up current because they wanna be the first thing that gets the bait when it's coming and getting pushed in by the current of the tide. So, we're gonna throw along this. I got this whole area. I get the fan cast and try. A lot of times, literally, like, you know, you could be 5 feet over or 20 feet over, and the fish, there's 1,000 fish. Whereas if you're, you know, back on this side, you might not even get a bite. So rig fishing, what you wanna do is you wanna kinda really fan cast and pick out and dissect that rig or this structure that's from the rig in the water. Now I'm fishing a popping cork, and the reason why is that, you know as well as I do, you see all of this different structure and, oh, there he goes, and pipes and stuff. Well, what's gonna happen is there's all kinds of junk under the water here. If I throw a bottom rig, which I'd love to throw a drop shot right here, I would lose every rig I got because it's just all the trash down there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna stick, another speckled trout, we're gonna stick with just fishing the front side of these pylons and that, and see what happens. Yeah, this is a little about 12 incher right here. Beautiful little speckled trout. Nice little fish, that's what I'm talking about. All right. Sorry, y'all. I didn't mean to be speckled trout here. I thought I was gonna get a, but that's all right. Oh. Are you ready, Kaylee? Okay, now what I'm doing is I'm just fishing live shrimp. You know, we have it accessible now from Campos Marina, where we get all of our shrimp from. I'm just putting it on a jig head the way I always hook it. I know everybody thinks it kills the shrimp, but it doesn't. It allows the shrimp to stay on the hook really good. My water's not super clear, so I don't have to fish like a kale hook or a treble hook to hide. It's kind of got a little murkiness to it, so what I want to do is I put that jig head with the chartreuse on it to just give it a little bit of something out there that might, you know, induce a strike, or they can see it a little bit better, because you know chartreuse shows up really well in kind of ish stained water, you know? So let's see what else is here. And we're gonna go, oh, there's another one. Yeah, they're right there. Okay, that's really nice, because I mean, I literally, this is my third cast, three fish. And what I'm doing is that I'm fishing this Versamax bolt. It's something to just keep that bait off the bottom. All right, let's see. Oh, that's a hard head. Now, we'll tell you, you see, trash fish like this hard head right here, he's poisonous. We don't want to mess with him. I'm going to show you what we use a lot here in Louisiana and on our charters. I mean, these things are like $1, $2 a piece. It's a little bent piece of metal, and it's a catfish flipper. A lot of guys use them when they use trot lines for catfish. Well, we use them for a poisonous fish because their fins are poisonous. It's different than a freshwater catfish. They actually have a slight little toxin inside of them that really hurts really bad. You don't want to have anything to do with it. So what you do is you take the curve of that hook, put it on the curve of your hook, hold it like that, you can see how it is, and then you're just gonna flip the whole catfish over, and the weight of him is gonna make it come off, just like that. And then you don't have to touch him, you don't have to worry about getting stuck by him and ruining your trip if you have this little tool. So check it out. I'll put a link at the bottom to pick them up. You can get them from any store around Louisiana has them, so I'm sure they got them all over the place. Academy Sports and Outdoors, they have them right there where the fillet knives and everything are. All right, let's throw in there. That was two trout and hardhead catfish. Let's try it again. Get up in there. Thank you. All right, there he is. Another speckled trout. So I just threw, I caught those few fish. Then I threw out twice, never got a bite. So what I did was I said, okay, now I got to start fan casting. I got to change it up. So I'm hitting the outlying pieces of the structure, which is the pylons. I threw right over there at another area. These fish may be scattered on the rig instead of schooled. Another really nice little speckled trout right here, probably about 13 inches, 14 inches. Beautiful fish. Got them right in the top of the mouth where we want them. I'm going to hurry up and take them. We're going to throw them back. We're not keeping fish today, so we want to hurry up and get them back in the water really quick. So that chance of living is really high compared to leaving them out and talking about everything. Now, the Versamax cork, the reason why you always see me using the hybrid, the 3.0, which is the plastic cork, okay? I got one. Hold on one second. I got one right here, okay? This is the hybrid right here. This one, I tend to use this a lot more for redfish. Got a lot more rattles in it. It just attracts the fish a lot better. Whereas this bolt, it's on a wire, a titanium wire, and it can go up and down and make noise that way. I can change my depth just like I can the hybrid. But the thing is that for me, as I'm fishing out here, I find the bolt, you don't have to pop it as hard as you do the hybrid, because the bolt has that wire in there. You're really just trying to bring that wire up to the cork. The cork goes forward, makes a little splash, and it attracts the fish. Oh, that one almost pulled it out of my hand. Oh, wait, he came back, got it? Nope, oh, but I missed him. But I'm talking, and sometimes you miss fish when you're talking. But the thing is that will attract those fish. I find speckled trout a lot better than the hybrid. That's just me. I find that the sound of that cork, it's not as loud and obnoxious, and I find that our trout like that. Trout don't really like a lot of crazy popping. They just like that little choop, choop every once in a while to call them up. Now, a lot of people ask me when they're fishing with me, they say that I tend to pop the cork. I want them to pop the cork a lot more than what they would on their fishing trip. And I always tell everybody, for speckled trout, as we're catching here, you want to give it like a one or two pop and then let it, oh, he missed it. One or two pop and then let it sit for about, I don't know, 3 seconds, 4 seconds. You don't get a pop, one or two pops, let it sit. 3 or 4 seconds, nothing. Kind of keep doing that. And you want to try to leave the cork, let the tide or the current move the cork for you. Don't try to pop and reel, because a lot of people do that when they come fishing with me, and they do that on their own. And when I explain it to them that you want this thing to stay in the strike zone, which is by the structure. If you take it away from the structure by popping and reeling, you're eliminating actually the area that the fish are sitting in. So you want to try to leave it there by leaving slack in your line and just giving a quick little pop. When it goes down, you can then hurry up and reel and catch the fish. And that's the proper way to do it. Other people have different ways of doing it. That's just the way that I like to do it. I find that it works very successful for me by me just giving a couple little pops, letting the tide do the work for you. You not moving it with the retrieve. I'm gonna try one more to see if that fish will hit it. The shrimp is dead now. My chances of getting a speckled trout are slim, because it really seems like they want that live bait. Probably get me a catfish instead. But we're gonna try it real quick. Okay, you ready? All right, now a lot of people, they like to hook the shrimp through the horn. So I'm gonna show y'all how to do that just in case. Okay, here's a little black dot, which is the brain. You wanna take that hook and place it right in front of that, go through the skull or the head, and then have it hang like this. That works really well also. The only thing that I find is that, especially with white shrimp, they don't stay on that hook that well. They come off a lot. Whereas if you thread them on from the tail towards the head, you get a lot more meat in there. You're not hitting any vital organs, and you got the fish. All right, this is something a little bit bigger. This may be like a little sheephead or something, or just a really nice speckled trout. Okay, let's see what it is. He liked to pull a pole out of my hand. And that was on that little bitty shrimp. You know, remember, oh, he got off. I was talking. I got to stop talking. But the thing is that he hit that little bitty shrimp. Remember, the shrimp right now, if you look in my bucket, look at all the shrimp. They're really small size. And the reason for that is that's what's out there right now in the water. We're in early spring. The shrimp aren't really big. So don't get knocked off that you're worried that you have too small a shrimp. Doesn't matter, I promise you. The fish are seeing that size shrimp right now. That's there. It's kind of what we say, match the hatch. So let me kind of throw out there again. I think that was a big sheephead. He really hit it fast and he got kind of caught up in some structure there, up in there. Wiping me clean. And let me tell you, this fish, now this just shows, I caught him and he went right into the structure and got all flipped around. I could feel him like getting all in it. I took my time, I didn't pull him real hard. I just kind of let him get his way out of it. I'm sure there's some pylons under the water there or something. Another speckled trout, and he was all up inside of it, and he got lucky today because I'm letting him loose, but I got lucky because I could have lost all my rigging being stuck in there. But knowing that if I pull and I really rip him out of there, he's gonna end up getting stuck and get my jig head caught in a pylon, or I'll lose my cork. So what I want to do is I'm gonna take him and just kind of hold a little bit of tension. He'll work his way kind of through it and out of it, because there is a little bit of tension coming this way, and it came right out. Exactly what you should do. I mean, that's textbook. It worked perfect. Another one. Man, let me tell you, this has been really fun today. And I mean, I've only been fishing for about an hour, and I've caught a bunch of speckled trout, a couple of hardheads. I had a sheephead on, but I thought I'd catch more sheephead, but I didn't. Let's see what this is. I think it's a speck. Yeah, speckled trout. And they're just on this structure. So what I kind of want to get to you in, you know, fishing on structure like this is not really think about this as a rig, but think of this as like structure. So what we have here, let's get this little speckled trout off so I don't hurt him. Nice one. He's about, I don't know, about 14, maybe 15 inches. And what I want to tell you is you see the structure, okay? Current's coming in and going across like this. We know that we can fish the upsides of all of these pylons. I never had to move today, but I did have to catch, like I was catching here for a little bit, then here, then here. I caught one hard head back here. I came back up and I'm just fan casting and I'm picking these fish up. So what you want to know is that when you're fishing, you always want to fish the upside current of the rigs, okay? You can catch them on the down current, but I always find on an incoming tide, this time of year, we've got incoming tides during the day. Good, salty, fresh water is coming on in. It's doing really good going back into the marsh. And all of that good water brings in shrimp and croakers and pogies and all of the bait, little crabs, brings them through. Those fish are going to be right at the front of that pylon waiting for something to come out from open water into those rigs, because that bait also is looking for protection, just like the speckled trout are from porpoises or jack crevels or sharks. So always remember that. To try the upcurrent side, make sure you meticulously fan cast in between all of this. Use a popping cork, because I can promise you, you fish on bottom around structure like this, you're going to get stuck and lose a lot of tackle. So make sure, we'll put a link to the Versamax cork on there, the catfish flipper, and make sure you subscribe. And if you have any comments, put them down below and I'll try to answer them for you, okay? Hey, I'll see you next time in the water.